Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about Adobe InDesign, how to add page numbers to your ebooks. I downloaded this ebook for free from HubSpot, and you can do the same. I'll include that link in the description. So first I made facing pages with this because that's the normal way that you'll have to deal with ebooks is in a booklet form. And that's how I want to show you how to add page numbers to these. Okay, so first off, you'll want to go to your master pages, which are right up here in your pages palette. To bring that up, you'll go to Window, Pages, and just select it here. Okay, so first let's go to the A master, and I'll double click over here on the little page picture. Okay, now this will give us our master page, and it shows you whatever is on every single page. Right now there's nothing there. So I'm going to put my page number here and here. And let's just go ahead and get started. I'm gonna hit T to get the text tool and draw a little box here. And now I'm going to go to Type, Insert Special Character, Markers, and then Current Page Number. And that is how you get your page number into the document, and it will always be the current page number. So I'm gonna make this a little bit bigger. I'm gonna change my font, and then I'm gonna make it kind of a grayish color. And we'll put this down here in the corner, and you can draw guides if you like. You can just pull a guide over from your ruler, but I'm going to use the guides that are already set up in this document. So I'm going to zoom in with the Z tool, and now I'll make this box a little smaller. You can also add some other elements to make your page numbers a little more interesting. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. I'm hitting M to get the rectangle shape tool. I'm just going to draw a little rectangle here, and we'll make this orange. And now I'll draw another text box, and I'm just going to put the title of my ebook here, which is Stuff You Always Wanted to Know. Another thing I like to do with the page numbers on the left is justify them to the right. So to do that, Shift Command R, or you can come up here to the Align Right Paragraph tool. I'm gonna move that over. So now when it updates, it will go to the left instead of the right. Okay, and I'm gonna copy all of this and come over here to the right side and paste. I'm going to do something similar here just to match it up. And we'll make this one left justified. That's Shift Command L, or here in your paragraph palette. I'll just type a quick guide here. We'll right justify that to be about right there. If you look at your pages, they probably will all have the letter A up in the corner. So that means it's using this A master. And if you don't want the page number on that page, you can pull the none on top of that page just like that. And that will kind of cancel it. So let's look at our pages now. I'm gonna double click on page one. And as you can see, it's here, but I don't really want it on my front page. So I'll do none and pull it over top of that. And it makes it disappear. Let's look at page two. We can see it here. It doesn't look that great. I think I don't want it on my table of contents page either. So I'll do the same there. This isn't showing up because it's such a dark page on the back. So I'm gonna go ahead and make another master page so that this will show up and look good. So I'm gonna come up here to the master and pull this down a little. We'll come up here and go to new master. And we'll have two pages and say, okay. I'll double click here, grab this master. I'll double click here, select this and copy, and then double click on the B master, and then Shift Option Command V, which will paste it in place. Now on this one, I'm just going to change the color to paper of both of these things. And now I'm going to pull this right on top of that A one. Okay. So now it has a little B up in the corner. And now let's take a look at that. Okay, it shows up way better. Okay, this looks good over here. And good here. Obviously they don't really match, and I can adjust that by double clicking on the A master, maybe moving this a little further to the left. And then when we go back, we can see that it's updated and looks a little bit better. This is also a little too far over. So I'll double click here and move it to the right a little bit. And for this last page, I'm going to go ahead and grab that B master again and pull it on top of the page here, and that'll update that page number. So I hope this was helpful for you guys. Please let me know if you have any questions in the comment section below. If you like this video, please click on the like button, and I'll see you next Thursday. Thanks, guys.